Here to give you Sabbath Sunday service starting at 11:30 a.m. Hallelujah. We welcome you and we would like to pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we come humbly to your holy throne, Heavenly Father, praying in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that your spirit will reign through this service in the name of Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That you would strengthen us, Father God, and give us peace that passes all understanding in the name of Jesus, Lord. Give us joy, hallelujah, that no man can give it or take it away in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Rebuke the devourer for our sake in Jesus' holy name, and let us praise you in the truth and in your way, in the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Let us praise you in the truth and in the Spirit. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I pray for Blessed Assurance Ministry to be lifted up. I pray for Blessed Assurance pastors and minister and children of Blessed Assurance to be lifted up in Jesus' holy name. Glory to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. Praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Give them our highest praise today. In Jesus' name, amen. into this house to gather in his name to worship him. We have come into this house to gather in his name to worship him.
Lift up hands.
Hallelujah.
We have come into this house.
Come on now.
To gather in his name to worship Christ our Lord. Worship him.
Come on now.
Worship him.
Concentrate on God to worship him. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let's
forget about ourselves.
Woo!
Concentrate on God to worship him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let's forget about ourselves and concentrate on God to worship Christ our Lord. Worship him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Worship him.
Psalms 97. And now I'm gonna pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name I come, Lord, in the name of Jesus. God, that you bless the Blessed Assurance Temple Living God and the body members of the body of Christ, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, because we know that you're able, Lord, to do anything but fail. In Jesus' name. We know, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you're able to bless this service, Lord, and saturate it in your power and saturate it in your anointing, Lord, the kind of anointing that breaks yokes in the name of Jesus. We give you the thanks and we give you the praise in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Come on.
Magnify our Lord,
for He is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation.
Thank you, Jesus. Come on.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hosanna. Blessed be the rock. And may the rock of my salvation be exalted. We're going to ask everybody stand for Psalms 97. Read another word. Amen. Psalms 97, 1 through 12. The Lord reigneth. Let the earth rejoice. Let the multitude of isles be glad thereof. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Righteousness and judgment are the habitation of his throne. A fire goes before him and burneth up his enemies round about. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
His lightnings enlighten the world. The earth saw and trembled. Thank you, Lord. The hills melted like wax at the presence of the Lord. At the presence of the Lord, the whole earth. The heavens declare, thank you, Lord, his righteousness. And all the people see his glory. Confounded be all they that serve graven image, but boast themselves of idols. Worship him, all ye gods. Hallelujah. Zion heard and was glad, and the daughters of Judah rejoiced because of thy judgment.
Amen.
O Lord, thank you, Jesus. For the Lord art high above all the earth. Thou art far above all gods. Ye that love the Lord, hate evil.
Amen.
And he preserves the souls of the saints. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
He delivers them out of the hands of the wicked.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Light is sown
thank
for
you,
the righteous, and the gladness for the upright in heart. Last verse. Rejoice in the Lord, ye righteous, and give thanks and remember of his holiness.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Give him the highest praise.
Praise
give him glory.
Lord. Glory. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise and worship. Hallelujah.
You don't know like I know what he's done for me. Oh, you don't know like I know what he's done for me. Oh, I know what he's done for me. Oh,
put your hands together.
when there's a praise in the temple and a praise in the house, ushering the spirit, move the devil out. Open up the windows and the blessing will come out. When there's a praise in the temple and a praise in the house, when there's a praise in the temple and a praise in the house, you can usher in the spirit and remove the devil out. Open up the windows and the blessing will come out. When there's a praise in the temple and a praise in the house, there's a praise in the temple and a praise in the house, you can usher in the spirit and remove the devil out. Open up the windows and the blessing will come out. When there's a praise in the temple and a praise in the house,
It's service time.
Enter into the gateway and a praise on your mind. It's service time. Get up out of that seat. Get up on your feet. Let's clap to the beat. It's service time. Enter into the state and a praise on your mind. It's service time. Get up out of that seat. Stand up on your feet. Let's clap to the beat. It's service time. You won't leave like you came when Jesus came. There's a blessing waiting for you. You can claim it. All you have to do is say, with your name, you won't leave like you came in Jesus' name. You won't leave like you came in Jesus' name. There's a blessing waiting for you, you can claim.
I pray and hallelujah.
Yeah.
Jesus!
Just in His name, you won't leave like you came in Jesus' name. It's service time. And a praise on your mind. It's service time. Get up out of that seat. Stand up on your feet. Let's clap to the beat. It's service time. Praise in the temple. Praise in the house. Usher in the spirit, move the devil out. Open up the window and the blessing will come out. When there's a praise in the temple, 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 praise in the temple. Come on, there's a praise in the temple.
Hallelujah.
And a praise in the house.
Hallelujah.
You can usher in the spirit.
Glory.
And you
Hallelujah.
Can kick the devil off.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank
That's
you.
What it's all about, kicking the devil off.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Glory.
Thank you,
we worship
Jesus.
You. I shout it out. We worship your Father. Glory.
Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I call Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy to bear in mind. I'm not saying, yeah, we are. Oh, Lord, you bear in mind. Happiness is mine. Happiness is mine. Happiness today is mine. I told Satan, get me high. Happiness today is mine. When I woke this morning,
hallelujah,
I didn't have no doubt. I knew that the Lord would bring me out. I fell on my knees, said, Lord, help me, please. Now sing and shout victory. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Victory is mine, victory is mine, victory today is mine. I told Satan, you better get behind me. You can't stop me. Get close, say, you can't block me. You can't stop me. Get thee behind. I told Satan, I rebuke you, I rebuke you, I rebuke you, I rebuke you. Get me high. Whoa, victory today is mine.
Jesus.
Come on, victory is mine.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Victory is mine.
Jesus on the main line.
Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Call him up. Tell him what you want.
Hallelujah. If you want your soul saved,
tell him what you want. Oh, if you want your soul saved, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want your soul saved, tell him what you want. Call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want that Holy Ghost, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want that Holy Ghost, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want that Holy Ghost, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, main line, tell him what you want. Oh, main line, tell him what you want. Oh, main line, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up and tell him what you want. Oh, if you want your body healed, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want your body healed, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want your body healed, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want deliverance, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want deliverance, tell him what you want. Oh, if you want deliverance, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, call him up, tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus on that main line, Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Oh, call him up. Tell him what you want.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Now we're going to ask Brother Izzy to come up and give us the Lord's Prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, Father, Lord in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us a day our daily bread, forgive us our debts, forgive us our sins. Lead us not to no temptation, but deliver us from all sin and evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory. Amen. Hallelujah.
Now I'm going to ask everybody to stand. We're ready to do our communion, our holy communion. Amen. We're going to ask our prophet to pray a blessing over our communion.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we come humbly to your holy throne, Heavenly Father, asking, Father God, that you will continue to bless us, protect us, and keep your Holy Spirit within our souls. Keep your Holy Spirit within us in Jesus' name. And let your Holy Spirit always have its way, Lord God. For this we do in remembrance of you, Heavenly Father. For you are our bread of life, thank Heavenly Jesus. Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Lord. For your holy blood shed on Calvary was shed for us, Father God. You took all of our sins and iniquities and you took them all upon you, Father God. But you knew no sin. But at Calvary, you took
thank
it all
Jesus.
For us, Father God. And we receive what you have done for your crucifixion, your death, burial, and your resurrection. And we pray blessings over us with your your resurrection. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 26. It says, for as often amen.
Lord, we love you.
Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, thank you, Jesus.
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 Lord, you're holy.
Lord, you're holy. Lord, Lord, you're holy.
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 Lord, I love you.
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 Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. So we got to understand. And when you take this communion, you can't have no hate, no envy, no evilness in your heart. You must take it with a pure heart, a pure mind. And it is best that you be assembled, you know, in the body of Christ, that you may receive the blessing, the favor, the anointing, the power, the deliverance, that the Lord has for you this day. Because it is clear, if you take this unworthy, hallelujah, you'll add greater condemnation to your soul. So let a man examine himself, and let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. If you eat and drink unworthy, you add grave damnation to yourself, not deserving the Lord's body. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you, to do in remembrance of me. Take, eat. After that man also he took the cup, and he said, this is the New Testament in my blood. This do often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Drink. Amen. Give God some glory. Give God some praise.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Give God some glory. Give God some praise. Hallelujah. Because God is worthy. Isn't he worthy to be praised? He died for you that you may have life. And that you may have what? Life eternal. So give him praise. Give him glory. On this day. Remember, this is his day. Remember, this is the day that the Lord has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. We're going to ask prophet to come forth.
So I would like to share our testimonies. Is there any testimonies in the house today?
I just want to give honor and glory to God for that. This is the day that he has made. This is the week of the devil's defeat. This is the month of the Lord's triumph. This is the year that the Lord is near. I thank God for how he brought me out of darkness into his marvelous light. I thank God for the prophet, my children. I thank God for the household of faith. But those in the body of Christ, I thank God for the views and everyone here. I'm asking you to pray for the Blessed Assurance Ministry. Pray for one another that we walk in the goodness of God in these last and evil days. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. I testify, I'm thankful for the blood covenant, hallelujah, the holy blood covenant of Jesus Christ, our Savior. The Lord said that he will be mindful of our blood, of the holy blood covenant that he has made. I'm thankful for communion today, hallelujah, glory to God. I'm thankful for my family, my ministry family. I'm thankful for my children, my husband, which is my ministry family also, hallelujah. I'm thankful for all the blessings that God has done for me, all the blessings that he is doing, and all the blessings that he is yet to do. I'm thankful, hallelujah, glory to God, for the Holy Spirit, glory, hallelujah. And I'm so thankful for God's holy promises, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus, amen. Now, for announcements. And our announcements are, Righteous Talk airs Tuesdays at 8:30 p.m. The radio station that Blessed Assurance Temple of Our Living God airs at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Wednesdays and Thursdays. Radio station, Pastor?
Amen.
Okay, so we have Righteous Talk airs Tuesdays, 8:30 p.m. The radio station airs on Wednesdays and Thursdays at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Righteous Talk Daily Message, 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And with Righteous Talk, you know, we don't always, it's always definite that we're going to do Righteous Talk at 8:30 on Tuesdays Eastern Time. But, you know, the daily message, we give daily messages and Righteous Talk. So you may get a lot of them on before, you know, Tuesdays. We may, if God gives us, you know, the unction to do it whenever, you know, in the morning or in the night, in the middle of the night, whatever God gives us to do it, we do it. So we are constantly doing Righteous Talk, and it airs constantly. So, but we try to set a set schedule for it. But if the Lord gives us a message and tells us to go and teach that message for Righteous Talk, we have to feed, we got to feed, you know, those who hunger for God's holy word. So daily messages for Righteous Talk. Don't forget to tune in daily for daily messages for Righteous Talk. The radio station, Wednesdays and Thursdays at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. You don't have to contact us to be part of or be a guest on the radio station teaching on the goodness of God, godly conversations, and just, you know, elaborating in the goodness of God on the radio station. If you would like to be a guest on our radio station, you just have to dial a number and you will be connected automatically. And that number is 1-646-716-9915. I'll repeat it again. You don't have to add any more numbers. Just dial this number straight up. 1-646-716-9915. Wednesdays and Thursdays, 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Pastor, do we have that right for the radio station?
6:30.
No, I'm talking about, I know it's 6:30, but is it Wednesdays and Thursdays?
It's Mondays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays.
I'm sorry about that. The radio station airs Mondays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Dial that number and you will be joined then to our radio station automatically. You don't have to contact us. You don't even have to let us know that you're coming. Come on and join in with our Blessed Assurance Temple of Our Living God Ministry radio station. Just dial 1-646-716-9915 and you will be joined in with us and we will welcome you. Hallelujah. Live callers, goodness of God, get yourself booked for Righteous Talk to be a live caller or to share your testimony, doing live interviews in person. Get booked and call our Righteous Talk department at 814-695-1203. Follow the prompts and it'll take you to Righteous Talk department. You can email us if you're interested in being part of Righteous Talk, being a live caller or being Skype or being live interview, sharing the goodness of God, testimonies, teaching a message. As long as it's God led, we welcome you. Hallelujah. You can also email us information on times that you want to be available for Righteous Talk Live. Our email address is righteoustalk12@gmail.com. Our email address for Righteous Talk, if you'd like to get booked, you can email us or you can call us. Our email address is righteoustalk12@gmail.com. And if you'd like to call in, also 814-695-1203. Hallelujah. So, live interviews by appointments only. So make sure you call that number for live interviews, because you have to make an appointment to be a live caller and to have live interviews. 814-695-1203. We have our bottom mile program. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you are in the Blair County area and you would like to get some assistance with the Bottom Mile Food and Clothing Program, give us a call, 814-695-1203. Go to the Bottom Mile Department, follow the prompts, and a representative will return your call in the order that it was received, and we will kindly help you in your time of need. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We also have our prayer line. If you need prayer, if you would like to leave a prayer request, if you would like to unite in prayer, touch and agree with blessing assurance with your prayer, 814-695-1203. Go to the prayer request department and leave your prayer request. If you'd like to speak with a representative, make sure that you get a representative. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. And that will do for our, I have one more announcement. Blessed Assurance Temple of Our Living God Ministry email address is blessedassurancetemple@gmail.com. Also, if you would like to make a donation to the Blessed Assurance Temple of Our Living God for a building fund or for the Bottom Mile Food and Clothing Program, please give us a call or email us at blessedassurancetemple@gmail.com or go to the donation button on our channel here. Go to About Us and go to the donation button and make your donation in Jesus' name. Or you can call the ministry number, and it's 814-695-1203. Follow the prompts and go to the donation department. Hallelujah. Be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to praise the Lord while I have a chance.
the morning. Praise Him all day long.
I feel like praising Him. Do you feel like praising Him? Come on. Don't hinder me. Come on, prophet. Let me sing it to you. Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him all day long.
I feel like praising
Him. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on. I feel the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. God is able. You hear that? God is able. Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Jesus. And turn to his gates with thanksgiving to his courts with praise. Be thankful to heaven and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth for all generations.
Hallelujah. That was Psalms 100 by Usher Dooley.
We're going to ask the prophet to come forth.
Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory.
Hallelujah, thus saith the Lord. Asking, seeking, and knocking. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you, Lord. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus presented the three rims of prayer. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Ask, and it shall be given unto you.
Given.
Seek, and ye shall find.
Shall find.
Knock, and it shall be opened. The door shall be opened. Hallelujah. Glory to God. For everyone that asks, receiveth. Glory. Hallelujah. The Lord said that everyone that asks with a pure heart and believing that they receive it, they shall be receiving it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah. As he taught this Sermon on the Mount, three realms of prayer. There are three realms of prayer. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Ask, and it shall be given unto
thee.
Seek, and ye shall find.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Believe, and it shall be
unto you.
Glory, hallelujah. The book of Matthew, hallelujah, 7:7-9 tells us, hallelujah, about how Jesus spoke about believing and receiving in your prayer realm in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. The Old Testament shows us how to enter into God's presence. And it uses a tabernacle as a map that leads us through those life-changing realms. Hallelujah. Glory to God. From the outer court to the holy place and into the holy of holies. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.
Amen. God some glory.
I feel like praising Him. Oh, I feel like praising Him.
Praise Him in the morning.
Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him all day long. I feel like praising Him.
If you don't want to go, don't hinder me.
If you don't want to go, don't hinder me.
Oh, if you don't want to go, don't hinder me. Hallelujah.
Praise Him in the morning.
Praise Him in the morning.
Praise Him all day long. I feel like praising Him.
Come on, one more time. If you don't want to praise Him, you don't want to praise Him, don't hinder me. Oh,
you don't want to praise Him, don't hinder me.
Don't bother me. Hallelujah. Glory.
Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him all day long. I feel like praising Him.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
So we're going to go. Before I go into the Word of God, I'm going to say a little prayer. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength, my redeemer. Amen. Now we're going to get in the Word of God and the name, the title I have for this Sunday is Being in the Place of God. Being in the Place of God.
Amen.
So sometimes in life, people are not going to treat you fair. Amen. People will hate you because of being jealous or because they have evil intentions. But we just got to be aware of our surroundings. Hallelujah. We got to have that what? That spiritual awareness. We got to have that what? Physical awareness. The Bible is clear. He said, be sober and be vigilant because what? Your adversary, the devil, walketh as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Hallelujah. We got to understand everybody is not going to like you. Thank you, Jesus. They're not going to like your stance for God. Thank you, Jesus. But it's okay. It's up to you to stand and be in the place of God. Can I get some help here? It's okay for you to be in the place of God. Make sure that we stand, you know, in the place of God. Because by us standing in the place of God, we're standing in the righteousness of God. And we stand in the righteousness of God, we cannot dwell in the ungodly counsel of God. The Bible is clear, says, blessed is the man, this is Psalms 1, that walketh not in the counsel of what? The ungodly, nor standeth in the way of the sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Why? His delight's in the law of the Lord. And in his law shall he meditate, what? Day and night. And he shall be planted by the rivers of water. Hallelujah. That brings forth fruit. Thank you, Jesus. In his season. Hallelujah. His season shall be what? Blessed. His season shall have favor. His season shall have joy. His season shall overcome in the midst of the storm. We just got to make sure that we what? We stand in the place of God. Hallelujah. Not in the flesh, but in the spirit. The Bible was clear. He said, walk not in the flesh. Thank you, Lord. But in the spirit. Hallelujah. The Bible says, walk in the light as he's in the light. Thank you, Jesus. So we got to make sure that we what? We stand in the place of God. Hallelujah. The Bible is clear. You know, don't be angry. You can have righteous anger, but don't let that anger cause you what? To sin. God wants us to what? Stay up in righteousness that we can be what? In the place of God. If somebody talks about you, you know what? Instead of talk about them, you pray for them that Amen. You can stay Amen. In the place of God. When your enemies come against you, you know what? Don't try to take vengeance yourself. God said he's your avenger. He said he'll fight your battle. He said vengeance is yours. He is his. He'll repay. Thus says the Lord. If we learn to do that, now we're staying what? In the place of God. Hallelujah. Are you able today to stand in the place of God? When people persecute you, are you able to stay in the place of God? When people talk about you, are you able to stay in the place of God? When people mistreat you, are you able to stand in the place of God? When people despise you, are you able to stand, hallelujah, in the place of God? Hallelujah. Even when, you know, your family members betray you, are you able to stay in the place of God? When your enemies come against you, we need to stay in, hallelujah, the place of God. Hallelujah. It's time for us as Christians to stay in the place of God. We go to Romans 8:28. And the Bible is clear. It says, we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. Hallelujah. So shall we say to these things, if God be for us, who could be against us? We're more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. But we just got to call on his name. We just got to believe on his name. We just got to have confidence in his name. We just got to have a surety in his name that he'll do exactly what he said that he'll do. We must believe that God will fight your battles. Hallelujah. Because we got to understand that the battle is not ours, but it is the Lord's. And if it's the Lord's, that means we walk in righteousness, that we're staying in the place of God. Point A. All things will work in your favor if you love God. So you got to love God if you want things to what? Work in your favor. We're not talking about some false God. We're not talking about the God of the Muslim faith. We're not talking about the God of the atheist faith. We're not talking about the God of the Buddha faith. We're talking about the true living God, the one that came down in the flesh, asked Jesus to save your soul from what? Sin. To give you an opportunity to have what you got wrong, to get it right today, that you may have what? Good life down here and have blessings and favor and eternal life up there. But we got to make sure that we work Things will work in your faith if you love the true and the living God. Hallelujah. Point B, God will fight your battles if you stay in the place of God. So we're going to talk about Joseph, right? Joseph means may God add what? Blessings. May God add prosperity. May God add deliverance. May God add protection. Yeah. Hallelujah. So let us tell you about Joseph. Joseph was at 17 years of age. Hallelujah. Joseph was given a coat of many colors by his father Jacob. We're talking about the same Jacob and Esau. But Joseph's father was Jacob. Hallelujah. And Jacob, because he liked Joseph, he gave him what? A coat of many colors. Hallelujah. And when his father Jacob gave him this coat of many colors, we got to understand that his 10 brothers that Joseph had were jealous of him. Sometimes we have people that are what? Are jealous. Am I right about it?
Amen.
Sometimes we have people that have evil intentions. Am I right? Sometimes we have people that hate you without a cause.
That's
Am
right.
I right? But we got to learn how to put on the armor of God. Hallelujah. We need to put on that helmet of salvation. Hallelujah. We need to put on that shield of faith. Hallelujah. We need to put on the shoes of peace. Hallelujah. We need to put on the mind of Christ that we may stay in the place of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Joseph, when he had this coat, hallelujah, that made him stand out from the rest. Today, let me ask you, because you're saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, because you're a believer on Christ Jesus, that means you stand out from the rest. Hallelujah. And the reason why you stand out from the rest, because why? You got the power, the anointing, and the favor, and the blessing of God resting upon you. Am I right about it?
Amen.
Because we stand out from what? Ungodliness. We don't go to unrighteous places. We don't go to the clubhouse. We don't go to the bar and talk about we got to drink a 7-Up. The Bible says we need to come into the Lord's house. That's right. Some people say, well, I go to the bar to drink a 7-Up. Well, truth is, you're dwelling in the house of wickedness. You're dwelling in the house of iniquity. You need to dwell in the house of the Lord. You know, don't go to the bar and say, well, I'm going to drink a soda. I'm going to drink a 7-Up. I'm going to drink a Coke. I'm going to drink a Pepsi. The Bible says, well, taste and see how good the Lord is. You know, we need to drink of his living water. Hallelujah. The kind of water that what? Won't have you thirst again. You know, God don't want us to go after those ungodly desires. Hallelujah. If you go into an ungodly place, there's an ungodly atmosphere. And if you're in an ungodly atmosphere, it's going to bring forth ungodly desires, which can cause a person to fall into unrighteousness and sin. But we as
That's
Christians
right.
should have the mind, the intelligence, the wisdom, and the understanding of Christ to know that we shouldn't go into those ungodly places. We shouldn't dwell into a house of iniquity. We need to dwell what? In the house of praise, that we stay in the place of God. Now, when we do come into God's house, we need to enter to his gates, hallelujah, with thanksgiving, hallelujah, and into his courts with praise, hallelujah. We need to be thankful unto him, hallelujah, and we need to bless his name, hallelujah, that we can stand in the place of the Lord, hallelujah, because God has a place for each and every believer, hallelujah, but he also has a place for the ungodly, hallelujah, with the place that he has, hallelujah, for the righteous. The Bible says, hallelujah, no eye, thank you, Lord, has seen, hallelujah, or entered into the heart of man, which the Lord has prepared for them that love him, hallelujah. The Bible is clear. He said, in my Father's house are many mansions, hallelujah, and if it were not so, hallelujah, I would have told you so, hallelujah. He said, I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, that you may be also. Hallelujah. God came, hallelujah, to give you life, hallelujah, to give you more abundance, hallelujah. He came to give you blessings, hallelujah, that will overtake you in the city, hallelujah, out of the city, hallelujah, in the field, hallelujah, out the field, in the name of Jesus. But you got to stay in the place of the Lord, hallelujah. If you want to be blessed, hallelujah, you got to stay in the place of the Lord. Hallelujah. What is your place with God? Hallelujah. To live right. Hallelujah. To act right. Hallelujah. To be right. Hallelujah. To think right. Hallelujah. To walk right. Hallelujah. When your enemies come against you. Hallelujah. You pray for them that they get salvation. Hallelujah. Use the word of God for your strength. Hallelujah. You put on the word of God for your power. Hallelujah. The Bible says, hallelujah, that there's no other name. Hallelujah. That men must be saved by. Hallelujah. But by the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. If you need salvation, you need to call on Jesus. Hallelujah. That you can be in the right place with God. Hallelujah. After you receive the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You have power over all the power of the enemy. That you stay in the place of God. Hallelujah. We have power. Hallelujah. To tread upon the serpents. Hallelujah. To stomp on the devil's head. Hallelujah. To cast them away. Hallelujah. We can sell to Satan. Hallelujah. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I come against you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I come against foul spirits in the name of Jesus. We as Christians, hallelujah, gotta stand in our place, hallelujah. We can't let nobody turn us to the right, hallelujah. We can't let nobody turn us to the left, hallelujah. We need to walk in God's righteousness, hallelujah. I know that we're able, hallelujah, because God gives us the power, hallelujah, to do these things in Jesus' name. Anything we do in word or deed, we got to do it in Jesus' name, hallelujah. If you're going through a situation, hallelujah, do it in Jesus' name, hallelujah. Pray unto the Lord, hallelujah, and he shall direct your path, hallelujah. We can't lean to our own understanding, because the good God, he will work it out, hallelujah. There's no doubt, hallelujah, that God will work it out, hallelujah. Even when your enemies, hallelujah, come against you, hallelujah. They can't stand, hallelujah, in the way of the anointing, hallelujah. God got a plan, hallelujah, and the devil can't stop it, hallelujah. Do you believe that today, hallelujah? Just like to deliver Joseph, hallelujah. God is able, hallelujah, to deliver you, hallelujah. If you stay in the place of God, hallelujah. Even though, hallelujah, Joseph got lied on, hallelujah. He stayed in the place of God, hallelujah. Even though Joseph got sold to slavery by his 10 brothers, he stayed in the place of God, hallelujah. Even though, hallelujah, they tried to take his life, he stayed in the place of God. Even though when he was in prison, he got lied on, but he stayed in the place of God. We today need to take that example and stay in the place of God. When your enemies think they got power over you, we need to go to Jesus and stay in the place of God. Even when Daniel was thrown in the lion's den, he stayed in the place of God, and God delivered him. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who were burned in fire furnace, they stayed in the place of God. Even Moses, hallelujah, when the people came against him, he stayed in the place of God. So it's the same thing for you. We need to stay in the place of God. Yes, people are going to lie on you, but stay in the place of God. People are going to persecute you, but stay in the place of God. Hallelujah. When a person of God or a servant of God receives something divine from God, receive it. Hallelujah. It's not coming from a man. It's coming from God. It's not natural. Hallelujah. But it's supernatural. Hallelujah. It's not human. Hallelujah. But it's divine. Hallelujah. It's not earthly. Hallelujah. But it's heavenly. Hallelujah. It's not fleshly. Hallelujah. But spiritually. Hallelujah. So open up your heart. Clean your mind. Let your heart receive it. Because it's God's word. Will surely come to the forefront. It will come to pass. The Bible's clear. In Isaiah 55:11. So shall my word be that go forth out of my mouth. It shall not come unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which it please. It shall prosper unto the things that I wanted to prosper. And even though Joseph was sold into slavery for 20 pieces of silver, even though Joseph was thrown to prison, even though Joseph continued to be in the place of God, Those dreams he told his brother that was going to reign over him, God brought it to pass. So don't worry when you get a word from the Lord and people disbelieve you. You got to stay in the place of God. Even though Noah was meant to build the ark, people laughed at him. People thought he was crazy. His family even forsake him. But he stood in the place of God. When that flood came, oh, when that storm came, hallelujah, what did Noah do? He was able to get into that ark. He was able to be in the safety of God. Because why? Even though he was persecuted, even though his family betrayed him, even people thought he lost his mind, he stayed in the place of God. And because he stayed in the place of God, what happened? Him and his family were saved from disaster. Him and his family ended up being in the place of safety. Him and his family were saved from the waters that destroyed the whole earth because he stayed in the place of God. That's what we should do today. People might think you're crazy. People might think you lost your mind. People will come against you. People will persecute you. People won't like you. People will lie on you. But we gotta stay in. Stay in the place of God. Hallelujah. Genesis 50 and 20. It declares, even though people mean for evil, God can mean it for good. He can turn your situation around that the devil meant for evil. But God meant it for good. Your enemies come against you. The Bible says he will raise up that standard against them. The Bible's clear. It's better that you leave it in his hands, that you can stay. Stay in the place of God. Hallelujah. Psalm 37 and 34 and 37. The Bible says, the angel of the Lord encamps round about them that fear him, and he delivers them. Hallelujah. Verse 38. Oh, taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed is the man that trusted in him. Psalm 37 to 17. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears them and delivers them. He delivers the righteous. Psalm 34, 19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of all of them. Do you have your trust in God? Do you have your faith in God? Do you have a confidence in God? Do you have a surety in God? You believe that God is a rewarder of them that are seeking him diligently. We got to seek him diligently in the morning. We get up in the morning, say, Lord, I thank you for you woke me up this morning. You're going to start me on my way. You're going to place my feet on a rock to stay. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is thy flow that makes me white as snow. No other fight I know. Nothing but the blood. Nothing but the blood. Nothing but the blood. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus comes to get your enemies today. The blood of Jesus is here today to straighten up situations which are not like Jesus. The blood of Jesus comes against your enemies. The Bible says there's only one angel that you can call on, and he'll come from heaven, and he'll dispatch his protecting angel over you. He'll dispatch his deliverance angel over you. He'll dispatch his way making angel. He'll dispatch his deliverance angel over your house. He'll bring your children that are lost back home. But you got
on him. You gotta have faith in him. You gotta have trust in him. You gotta have assurance in him. You gotta have faith. And don't doubt. Believe the word of God. The Bible's clear. He says life and death is in the power of the tongue. The Bible's clear. Let this mind be in you. That's in Christ Jesus. Is your mind on Christ Jesus? Is your heart fixed on Jesus? Is your walking in righteousness fixed on Jesus? The Bible's clear. Walk in the newness of God. Walk in the light. The Bible's clear. You should love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, and soul. And he will deliver you. He will give it joy. He will give you that financial breakthrough. He will give you those resources that you need. But you got to call on the name that's above every name. And his name is Jesus. So we thank God for the word. Stand in the place of God. Now I'm going to pray. Put your mind on Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that this word that went forth wasn't just another word, Lord. That we as believers, we as Christians, we as those trying to come to God, those of us that are in darkness, help us, Lord, to come into your marvelous light, Lord. That we be saved, that we may have eternal life and not eternal damnation, Lord. In the name of Jesus, that we may have joy. In the name of Jesus, in the midst of our storms. We have peace in the midst of our storms. Hallelujah. We have deliverance in the peace in the midst of our storms. We thank you, Lord. We praise you. We honor you. We magnify you. Lift your hands up. Lift those hands up. Today is the day for someone watching to receive your salvation. Today is the day that you'll be delivered from your bad habits. Today is the day that you shall come into the Lord. Today is the day that you can claim your unsaved children and come back into the fold. We give you the thanks, Lord, and we give you the praise. I pray that you honor these words which are sent forth. In Jesus' name, amen. Now we're going to turn it to the prophet. Close your eyes.
Righteousness and be pleasing to the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.